students myself, Hena Shah, assistant professor at LG Institutes of Engineering and Technology. So today we are going to discuss few more topics of Fourier series. So let us begin with the first topic, that is Fourier series of even and odd functions. So firstly, we'll discuss the definition of an even function. So if f of x is a given function defined over a symmetric interval minus L to L, then the function f of x is known as even function if f of minus x is equal to f of x for all x. Next, let us discuss the definition of an odd function. So let f of x be a given function defined over a symmetric interval minus L to L, then the function f of x is known as an odd function if f of minus x is equal to minus f of x for all x. So compulsory the interval should be symmetric, then only we can discuss the function to be even or odd. So let's see few examples of even and odd function. So let us take f of x is equal to x square. So in order to check whether it's even or odd, what we will do is we'll replace x by minus x. So that will be equal to minus x whole square, that is equal to again x square. So that is equal to f of x. Therefore we can say that f of minus x is equal to f of x. So by definition we can say that f of x is equal to x square is an even function. So let's see the graph of f of x is equal to x square. It is a parabola and you can see that it is symmetric about y axis. Hence from here we can say the graph of even functions will be symmetric about y axis. Next, let us see the function cos x. Again here we will replace x by minus x. So cos minus x, that will be again cos x. Hence we can say that cos x is an even function. Let's see a graph of cos x. Again here you can see that it is symmetric about y axis. So we have proved that the graph of even function will always be symmetric about y axis. Next, let us see the odd function x cube. Why it is an odd function? Let me give a brief idea. We'll replace x by minus x. So that will be equal to minus x whole cube. That is equal to minus x cube. So it will be equal to minus f of x. Hence, we can say that f of x is equal to x cube is an odd function. Similarly, let's see the graph of f of x is equal to x cube. Here you can see that the graph is symmetric about origin. Hence, the graphs of odd functions will always be symmetric about origin. Let's see one more example, that is of f of x is equal to sin x. So let us put in place of x minus x. So sin of minus x, that will be equal to minus sin x, and therefore it is equal to minus f of x. Hence f of x is equal to sin x is an odd function. Let us have a glance at the graph of sin x. Here also you can see that it is symmetric about origin. So now let us have a glance at the properties of even and odd function. So the first property is the graph of even function will be always symmetric about y axis. Next, the graph of odd function as discussed will be symmetric about origin. Next, the product of two even function. Let us take a product of x square and cos x. Obviously, it will be even. So the product of even functions will be even. Next, the product of two odd functions will also be an even function. For example, you can take x and sin x. So it will be an even function. Next, the product of an even and an odd function will be an odd function. For example, x and cos x. So product will be an odd function. Next, the sum or the difference of two even function will always be even. And next, the sum or difference of two odd function will be odd. So now let us see few more properties of odd and even function. So if f of x is an even function, very important property, then integration minus L to L f of x dx will be equal to 2 times integration 0 to L f of x dx. Very important property, again I am repeating. Next, if f of x is an odd function, then integration minus L to L f of x will be equal to 0. So here you can see that whenever it is even, it will be equal to 2 times integration 0 to L f of x dx, and for odd function it will be equal to 0. So now let us see the formula of Fourier series of an even function f of x in the interval minus pi to pi. So f of x will be given by a0 by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx. Here the function is an even function, therefore bn will be equal to 0 and a0 will be equal to 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x dx. An will be equal to 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx, and obviously bn will be equal to 0. Now let us see the formula of Fourier series of an odd function f of x in the interval minus pi to pi. So the Fourier series or the sine series will be given by f of x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx, where a0 and an will be equal to 0 and bn will be equal to 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x sin nx dx. So again I repeat, for even function bn will be equal to 0 and for odd function a0 and an will be equal to 0. So now let us go to an example, that is we have to find the Fourier series of f of x is equal to x in the interval minus pi to pi. So here you can see the interval is symmetric. So we can check whether the function is an even function or an odd function. So what we will do, the first step is we will replace x by minus x. So f of minus x will be equal to minus x, that is equal to minus f of x. Therefore by definition we can say that f is an odd function. So the values of a0 and an will be equal to 0. So only we need to find the value of bn. So bn will be equal to 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x sin nx dx. So just replace the value of f of x, that is 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi x sin nx dx. So now we'll apply UV rule, that is our Leibniz rule. So what is our Leibniz rule? Integration UV dx, that is equal to UV1 minus U dash V2 plus and so on. Here our integration is integration 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi x sin nx dx. So we'll consider this as u because it is an algebraic function and this as v. So now we solve using Leibniz rule. So keep x as it is, v1 means integration of sin nx. So that will be equal to minus cos nx upon n minus derivative of this will be equal to 1 and integration of minus cos nx, minus will remain as it is, integration of cos, that will be equal to sin nx upon n and this n, so it will be equal to n square, and before we have 2 upon pi and our limits are 0 to pi. Let's put the limits that is pi and 0. So firstly we will put the upper limit, that is equal to 2 upon pi. Start putting the upper limit. So it will be equal to pi times minus cos n pi upon n minus minus plus plus sin n pi upon n square. Now let us put the lower limit, that is 0. So if you put 0 in the first term, it will be equal to 0 plus sin 0 upon n square. So now we know some values, that is cos n pi. that is equal to minus 1 raised to n. Similarly, sine n pi, that is equal to 0. And lastly, sine 0 is equal to 0. So we'll start putting the following values. So this will be equal to 0, this will be equal to 0. So finally, what is remaining for bn? So finally, bn is equal to this pi also will get cancelled. 2 times minus minus 1 raised to n upon n. So finally, the answer of bn is minus 2 times minus 1 raised to n upon n. Now we'll put this value in our series. That is given by f of x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sine nx. So putting this value, you will get your final answer as minus 2 times sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n sine nx upon n. So this is your final answer of Fourier series. Now let us see one more example of Fourier series. That is, find Fourier series of f of x is equal to x square in the interval minus pi to pi, and hence deduce pi square by 12 is equal to 1 upon 1 square minus 1 upon 2 square plus 1 upon 3 square and so on. So firstly, the interval given is a symmetric interval minus pi to pi. So firstly, we will check whether it is an even or an odd function. Here you can see that it is an even function. So our bn will be equal to what? 0. So firstly, we'll start finding the value of a0 and an. So first, let us begin to find the value of a0. So a0 is given by 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x dx. So it will be equal to 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi x square dx. So integration of x square, it will be equal to x cube by 3 in the interval 0 to pi. Just replace the limits, and on simplifying, you will get the answer of a0 as 2 pi square by 3. Now similarly, we will find the value of an. So an is equal to 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx. So f of x is x square, so replace by that. Now in this, we have to apply UV rule, that is our Leibniz rule. So this will be your U and this will be your V. And what is your Leibniz rule? Integration UV dx, that is equal to UV1 minus U dash V2 plus and so on. So by using this and simplifying, you will get the answer of an as 4 upon n square minus 1 raised to n. And finally, put the values of a0 and an in our Fourier series, which is given by f of x is equal to a0 by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx. So value of a0, that is 2 pi square by 3. So finally, it will be pi square by 3 plus 4 times sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n square cos nx. So now, let us start the deduce part. So for that, we will firstly expand this summation. Firstly, put the value of f of x, that is x square. So x square is equal to pi square by 3 plus 4 into. Now, firstly, put n is equal to 1. So it will be equal to minus 1 upon 1 square cos x. Now put the value of n as 2, so it will be plus 1 upon 2 square cos 2x and so on. Now we have to deduce, so we will put the value of x as 0 in the above equation. So putting the value of x as 0, what you will get? 0 is equal to pi square by 3 plus 4 times minus 1 upon 1 square plus 1 upon 2 square minus 1 upon 3 square and so on. Firstly, you have to do the trial and error method in order to deduce the given thing. So what you have to put? Firstly, put the mid value. If not, then put the upper limit or lower limit and then prove the sum. So now we'll simplify this. So on simplifying, you will get the desired answer. That is pi square by 12 is equal to 1 upon 1 square minus 1 upon 2 square plus 1 upon 3 square plus and so on. So today, throughout the session, what we have studied? We have studied to find the Fourier series of an even and odd function on a symmetric interval minus pi to pi. So if the given function is an even function, then the value of bn will be equal to 0, and you only have to find the values of a0 and an. And if the given function is an odd function, then the values of a0 and an will be equal to 0, and you only have to find the value of bn. I hope you enjoyed studying the Fourier series of even and odd function with me. Thank you for watching.